Ladies and gentlemen, a very good evening and thank you for tuning into a brand new episode of The Nation Wants to Know, and I'm Deepthi Sachdeva. The Nation wants to know that for how long can we just be talking about what's been happening vis-a-vis women's safety? Once again, we are talking of women's safety. Once again, we will shine the spotlight on what's happened in Kolkata and what's happened also in Badlapur, what's also happened in Uttarakhand. The list is long. Everywhere. Everywhere you will realize that when netas are asked uncomfortable questions about you and me, about our safety, our friend's safety, our sister's safety, they kind of start to create excuses. No matter what, they can say beti bachao, beti padhao. They can call us the Adi, Abadi, Nari, Shakti, say absolutely anything. But when it comes to walking the talk, I want to begin by looking at two examples today. And that's exactly what we'll do, as we will be looking at two responses, remember, that have come in. One is Mamata Banerjee, when it comes to what happened in Kolkata, in spite of all these protests, in spite of people turning out in huge numbers, not just netas, what did Mamata Banerjee tell us? She said this is a Ram Bam conspiracy against Bengal. Ram here is what she signifies for the BJP, and Bam is for the left. So she sees a conspiracy. She also has said that this is an attempt to turn Bengal into Bangladesh, is what Mamata said. Now, if you just travel some kilometers from West Bengal, you get into Maharashtra, the chief minister is Eknath Shinde. Remember, there has been that absolute horror that has been reported from Badlapur again in the Thane district, just about 50 kilometers from Mumbai, the maximum city. What has he said today? He said this is a political conspiracy to malign my government. That is Eknath Shinde, part of the NDA. Don't forget, we are looking at elections in Maharashtra just around the corner. We've seen the entire opposition up in arms. They have also called in for a Maharashtra band. What you see on your screen are images that shocked everyone just about yesterday, because these are local citizens. This is not any politician. This is not any political party. These are only people. People who were so frustrated with the system, sleeping, continuing to sleep in their deep slumber. They wanted to wake them up. But Eknath Shinde says this is a political conspiracy. Before I move ahead, let's quickly listen in to these two responses, Mamata Banerjee and Eknath Shinde, and observe the line that both of them told.
Banglai Oshanti korte chan, Bam ebong Ram, tara ekottito hoye ei gondogol ta koreche.
Je kalcho je andolan hoto, e political motivated hoto, asa majha manne hai.
Remember, it's hard to believe that these are again chief ministers on different sides of the aisle. One is from the ruling dispensation, the NDA, the other is from the opposition, Trinamool. But their responses are very similar. Because, you know, it's just about us. It's about the women vote bank. And this is a vote bank that they believe that they can take for granted for far too long. I want to throw some numbers at you. It's important to do this. And believe me, for the last many, many days, as we've been covering the story, every day we speak about the data that comes in from the NCRB. These are data and numbers that should numb you. If this does not make an impact, we do not know what will. You have one case of rape that is reported in the country, ladies and gentlemen, every 16 minutes. One rape every 16 minutes. 42 cases of crime against women reported every hour. This was the year 2020. 42 cases every hour of crime against women. This is our India. 49 cases of crime against women reported every hour in 2021. Again, no one accountable. No one is asking questions. And netas will say this is all conspiracy. 51 cases of crime against women reported every hour in the year 2022. So what changes? Just a data up here, just a data down there. And that is why women's safety is nothing but about data. 31,516 cases of rape reported in 2022. 31,516 rape cases in 2022. These are just statistics for our netas. And that is why for them, this is a conspiracy. 248 cases of rape or gang rape with murder. So not just rape or a gang rape. These are also victims who are killed, who are silenced forever. 248 such cases reported alone just in 2022. What are we doing? Where are we going as a society? And like I said, all these are numbers that should leave all of us numb. We get shocked. We get very worried. But netas will also see a conspiracy. Now, not just a conspiracy, but I think because, you know, the focus of this episode of The Nation Wants to Know is also to expose and reveal the mindset of our netas. Netas cutting across political quarters. Whether it's a Rahul Gandhi who sees a distraction, to also remember netas who come in from different parties, whether it is the BJP, whether it is a Trinamool. Nothing changes. The joke, ladies and gentlemen, now is on us. We've had enough. Every time there is an election, these netas will, you know, talk of free electricity, giving us this free, talking of making us Labharti, talking of, you know, big schemes. But don't forget all this data that I've just showed you. But take a moment now to listen into a tons of these responses that have come to our newsrooms just over the last 24 hours.
पुलवामा में इतने सारे हमारा जवान भाई जान चला गया उसका, तो वो जवानों भाइयों, वो तो जस्टिस उसको नहीं मिला था। अगर जवान भाइयों ने बॉर्डर छोड़कर काम बंद करके यहाँ पर आए तो वो तो नहीं हो सकता है।
क्योंकि आपने कहा कि सरकार को टारगेट किया जा रहा, तो वही मैं पूछूं कि सरकार को टारगेट
किया जा रहा है।
सरकार, आप मानते हैं कि सरकार को टारगेट किया जा रहा है इसमें?
सरकार को टारगेट किया जा रहा है।
मैंने कलकत्ता के इंसिडेंट पे अपनी टिप्पणी करी है, अपने व्यू रखे हैं। यहाँ पे मैं डिस्ट्रैक्ट नहीं करना चाहता हूँ।
So maybe for netas, this is about distraction when you ask them pointed questions. But for us, it is not. You know, we all live through this every day. And like all of you have actually told us that you have always, always experienced one or the other story of, you know, how the world sees us, how do men deal with crime against women, and how do netas respond to this. Now, we've heard the netas, we've shown you a lot of these figures. But now I want you to listen in very, very carefully to every word of a lot of these, you know, doctors who've now begun to speak up. We don't want to reveal their identity because that could get them into trouble. But listen in to what they say. Do they feel safe at their own workplaces? Are they happy with the kind of arrangements that have been put in place after the entire horror that we have seen at the RG Corps Medical College and Hospital? Are they satisfied? Are CCTV cameras working? Are more guards around? Is the police right there helping them? Listen in.
We thought that the hospital was the safest place that we could go to. Like, you know, if we are traveling, if we are coming from home or if we are coming from somewhere, our parents would be very rest assured, have you reached the hospital? That means you are in a safe place. But that safety or security is something that cannot be assured anymore, at least in RG Corps. You see the hostels there, even after the day of this thing that happened that night, even after that, there were just, you know, one or two police people who were instated in below the hospital, the hostels. So that just makes things worse. Administration is not taking responsibility, the police is not taking responsibility. So we have nobody to go to. So it's very evident that people will feel unsafe out here.
How many of them are still currently residing at the hospital?
I think very few. I think like maximum 60% of people have left, 60-70%. Like 30% maybe would be, you know, residing out here. There were surely rape threats that happened to nurses, and there were people who tried to enter the ladies' hostel also, but they were stopped by, you know, our colleagues itself. So yes, it was a very bad condition. Give us enough forces who will be able to protect us and not run away like the Kolkata police did on the other day. I think we should be happy with that.
So is this also conspiracy? Does Mamata Banerjee or, you know, any other chief minister believe that whatever you heard from all these students is a conspiracy? Let's take the story ahead, because the story isn't over, because our netas continue to surprise us. Now, look at her. I'm not sure how many of you do recognize her, so I'll introduce her. She's a Congress MP. She's a Congress Member of Parliament, Praniti Shinde. Now, she clearly has been in politics long enough to understand the import of every statement, import of every word that you put out. We saw these images that have come in from Badlapur. Now she believes कि ये सब जो भी हुआ है, जितना भी विरोध हुआ है, ये बहुत हल्का था. She said that all this was very mellow. इससे ज़्यादा protest होना चाहिए था. She says, आग क्यों नहीं लगा दी गई? This is again, remember, not me saying this. It is not any other neta alleging this. This is the Congress's own MP provoking protesters, talking of anarchy. Is this now the next step ahead when you cannot save us, when you cannot ensure safety, when you cover up justice, you will go and provoke people? Listen in now to what she said.
कृत मानसिकता है लोगों में बाहर आ रही है क्योंकि सत्ता में जो है वो इसका समर्थन कर रहा है.
आज प्रोटेस्ट हो रहा था वहाँ पे,
मैं तो कह रही हूँ प्रोटेस्ट तो बहुत सभ्य था, वहाँ पे तो आग लगानी चाहिए थी. देखिए यही है, ये जो सत्ताधारी, हम तो DCM जो होम मिनिस्टर है उनका रेजिग्नेशन मांग रहे हैं. जो लड़कियों के लिए आते हैं उनके ऊपर लाठीचार्ज की जाती है
तो उनको तो आग लगा देनी चाहिए. दिस इज द कांग्रेस एमपी सेइंग दिस. And what is Congress's own Rahul Gandhi saying? The same Rahul Gandhi who, remember, earlier has spoken of a distraction. He says, unki nafrat ki dukaan hai, hamari mohabbat ki dukaan hai. Now, today he's taken to the social media and he says, where are we heading as a society? He's talking of multiple states that have seen such incidents of crime against women. He goes on to say that in Badlapur, the action happened only after protest. This is true. Had there been no protest, possibly there would have not been much action. He also says, has the Andolan now become mandatory for an FIR? He goes on to ask, why is it so difficult for victims to go to cops? Relevant questions. And these are good questions. Then he also, in fact, goes on to talk about not just we as a society, where are we headed? He says, we all need to come together to ensure that there is safety for women and there is justice. Justice for all. He says, justice or nyay, sabka adhikar. He says, instead of giving justice, cover-up is becoming the new norm. But I was looking for the word Mamata Banerjee in this entire tweet. I did not find that. And again, remember, I'm talking about this hypocrisy of netas on our show. We'll continue to do that. And I'll also bring up a panel of guests now here on the show. We have Shaina NC, who represents the BJP. We also have BD Singh Saab. He's the spokesperson of the Shiv Sena joining us. Kasturi Shankar is a noted actress also on the show. Vivek Bansalji is senior leader of the Congress Party. Sanjay Gupta represents the Shiv Sena UBT on the show. And Subrat Mukherjee is a political analyst. He leans towards a Trinamool. He's completing our panel. And Subrat ji, let's begin by asking you. Mamata Banerjee has been calling everything a conspiracy. She says, shadyantra hai, meri sarkar ko ukhaad fengna chahte hai, Bangladesh bana diya hai. May I ask you who's responsible and why is it that court after court has raised questions on Mamata Banerjee, sir?
Well, I like to begin with two statements. Vivekananda said that ultimately the level of civilization depends on the treatment of women, and there we are far from civilization. Second point is this countercharge and charge. Now, if you really look to the politicization of these issues, now if it would have been just a civil society initiative, then you could castigate Mamata Banerjee. But then the two political parties which are demanding her resignation, because they got eliminated in the electoral process, so they want extra constitutional mechanism to get rid of her. And that is not what I will call a responsible politics. So it depends on the level of politics, the level of culture, and the political debate that will really look to the responses. Now, if you really look to the larger issues that are involved, there is a crisis of governance in this country. The police administration has been pointed out many times.
Before you talk of the crisis of governance, sir, in the country, quote unquote, should we not talk of a crisis of governance in Bengal?
Of course we should, but we should link it with the larger issues concerned, because if you really look to the scale of governance, Uttar Pradesh is much less better governed than Bengal.
No, Subrajit, please. You know, I began again with the premise that we must not politicize each and everything. You know, politicians love to do that. That's the only way out, you know, Shaina. That they always will want to scuttle out of this. But Subrajit, before I get in Shaina here, for her first response to what's also happened in Badlapur, that's an equally horrifying story, Shaina. I have to ask Subrajit one more question. You know, today you have the CBI sources kind of not ruling out the fact that the ex-principal of the R.G. Carr Medical College possibly did enjoy some state patronage. Who has been shielding him, sir? Is he linked to the accused Sanjay Roy? And why is this man who is an ASI, he's been running the moment he sees the cameras? There are sources in the CBI who say that he possibly is again someone who's linked to the accused. He was guiding him, shielding him, and he possibly is the one who got the first call from the accused post the crime also.
Principle of law is one is innocent till proved guilty.
Please, so no, don't do this today. Subrajit, who are you defending today? Who are you defending today?
Please, just a minute. I will do it today. I will do it today because there must not be a media trial.
I've had this enough. Media trial. Do you remember how Mamata Banerjee responded when the Nadia rape happened? When the Park Street rape happened? Because there is a long and a checkered history of Mamata Banerjee responding to crime against women, sir.
One wrong does not justify another. The important point is there is a legal process. Supreme Court has also intervened. So be patient. That you remember the Nuremberg trial took years to complete. So there is a process. Let's have faith in the judiciary. And ultimately, let's wait
faith in the judiciary. But vote of no confidence in Mamata Banerjee. That's what the Supreme Court, sir, has said yesterday.
Supreme Court did not castigate her. That is, you are reading too much into the judgment. There was an overall prescription.
Problem
that
is with the people.
Implication.
Problem is with the upbringing of women. Problem
correct.
Is that rape is a social crime. Clearly, we've heard this for the last many, many days. Kasturi, I know you're equally fed up, you know, when you look at these responses coming in. Before I get you, I have to quickly ask a question of Shaina because we are talking of two mindsets. You know, whether this is about what happened in Kolkata versus what happened in Badlapur, Shaina. You know, the Shiv Sena has made a big charge. They allege that the police went slow in the entire case because apparently the school, the owner of the school has some links to a BJP neta. Is that true?
So first, please let me say, if there is an atrocity or a rape, be it Uttar Pradesh, West Bengal, Uttarakhand, UP, it really needs to be dealt with on the basis of what the issue is and the incident is. Let's keep politics aside. There are three aspects to every case, and we have seen particularly in Kolkata and Maharashtra. The fact is you have to have a proactive administration that does not tamper with evidence and produces it very diligently so that the political class can also be brought under pressure. And I say this with fear of law.
Shaina, all minute. Of you today finish. Can't talk as a third party. You can't talk as a third party anymore. You are stakeholders in governance.
Let me
much
just,
like the Trinamool is in Bengal. Shaina, I have asked you a very pointed question. Are these allegations true? Is the school under the radar right now linked to a BJP neta?
I'll tell you the difference between Kolkata and Maharashtra. The Chief Minister has already accepted that this was a wrong on behalf of the administration and the political class. He has set up an SIT. Ujjwal Nikam has already started the investigation. The case PDI has been brought in. FIR has been drafted.
Can you tell me why were the parents made to wait even here before an FIR is registered? Why were the parents asked to wait?
Look, there is a process of law, but you have to understand that when you accept that there is a wrongdoing, then you can correct it. And that's exactly what the Maharashtra government has done. Unlike
so,
Kolkata, where they
you know, August
the
13th, you have two, three and 4 year olds who are raped
point.
By the cleaning staff. August 16th, the parents reach the police station, you know, Kasturi, to file a complaint. August the 16th, the police says we are not keen on filing an FIR because apparently, as the opposition is alleging, Shaina, that the neta linked to the BJP, is linked to the school. That is the allegation the Shiv Sena is making. You are neither confirming nor denying this on the show. Parents are made to wait for over 12 hours. It's only later that an FIR is filed, Shaina.
Coming in. 1 minute, where is the question of BJP even being a part of the entire case? The case is very horrific. It is the biggest pervert of the universe who could conduct this kind and have this kind of a
Can
mindset.
Can you tell me whether the owner of the school is linked to the BJP or not? That's
I have
it.
No knowledge of this. I have absolutely no knowledge.
Okay,
I
you say you have no knowledge.
Of the case,
but somehow, the Shiv Sena has clear. Knowledge of this. Now, quickly, let me get in Sanjay and Kasturi. You will again just have to give me 30 seconds because I quickly want to check this. Now, Sanjay Gupta ji. शिव सेना का ये आरोप है कि क्योंकि ये पूरा स्कूल किसी भाजपा नेता ही चलाते हैं और उनसे रिलेटेड है इसलिए यहां पर एक्शन नहीं हुआ है। आपके पास क्या प्रूफ है या आप भी पॉलिटिक्स खेल रहे हैं?
नहीं, इस विषय में मैं सिर्फ ये कहना चाहूंगा कि सिर्फ सरकार माने और सरकार गिराने पर ही काम नहीं होना चाहिए बल्कि जिस तरह के आंकड़े रेप के आपने प्रस्तुत किए उससे इस बात पर और इस तरह की पॉलिसी को बनाना भी जरूरी है। क्या ऐसा किया जाए कि जिससे कि इस तरह के रेप रुक सके? क्योंकि
देखिए सबसे पहले तो आप सब लोगों को इस्तीफा दे देना चाहिए ना, क्योंकि आप लोग अपनी जिम्मेदारी नहीं लेंगे। अगर आप लोग कुछ कर नहीं सकते, सब लोगों को अपनी सुरक्षा खुद करनी है, तो हमें नेताओं की क्या जरूरत है? अब आप मुझे बताइए, ममता बनर्जी कोलकाता में जिस तरह का कवर अप करती है, क्या उसके खिलाफ आप लोगों ने आंदोलन किया है? उसके खिलाफ आप बंद बुलाएंगे या आपको सिर्फ महाराष्ट्र में जो घटना दिखती है उसके खिलाफ बंद बुलाएंगे?
आंदोलन और बंदों से वो पॉलिसियां नहीं बनेंगी जिससे कि इस तरह की घटनाएं रुक सके। इस विषय में हम सभी को बैठ करके अच्छे से विचार करके सही पॉलिसी को बनाने की जरूरत है, उस पर सही तरीके से मंथन करने की जरूरत है। सिर्फ ये नहीं देखना चाहिए हमने किसकी सरकार घेरनी है, किसकी सरकार।
अरे संजय जी अभी हमने शो में एक ग्राफिक चलाया, आपको पता है कि हमारे देश में हर घंटे कितने रेप होते हैं? आपको ये पता है सर, ये आंकड़ा पता है आपको?
उस आंकड़ों को देखने के बाद ही मैंने आपसे कहा कि हमें इस बात पर गहन विचार करना चाहिए और इस तरह की पॉलिसी को बनाना चाहिए।
नहीं तो अभी कोई तो जिम्मेदारी लेगा ना संजय जी, कोई तो जिम्मेदारी लेगा।
हम सभी की जिम्मेदारी है ये, जितनी भी हम पॉलिटिकल पार्टीज हैं, जितनी भी सरकारें, चाहे वो किसी की भी सरकार हो, किसी भी पार्टी की सरकार हो, कोई भी पॉलिटिकल पार्टी या सरकार किसी रेप को समर्थन नहीं करता।
नहीं तो ममता बनर्जी को तो यहाँ साजिश दिखती है, वो कहती है सब कंस्पिरेसी हो रही है।
कंस्पिरेसी किसी अपराधी की हो सकती है, कंस्पिरेसी सरकारों की नहीं हुआ करती। कंस्पिरेसी जिन अपराधियों की होती है उस कंस्पिरेसी को रोकने के लिए हम सरकारों को ही कोई कानून और कोई पॉलिसी बनाने की जरूरत है। तो इसलिए इस मामले में हम सभी को गहन चिंतन करके सही पॉलिसी।
अरे आप लोग क्या गहन चिंतन करेंगे, महाराष्ट्र में चुनाव आ रहे हैं, आपको लगता है ये राजनीतिक मुद्दा बनाया जा सकता है? तो आपको लगता है इस पर बंद बुलाया जाए? ममता बनर्जी कोलकाता में खामोश रहती है, उसके खिलाफ आप कुछ नहीं करते?
नहीं तो क्या मतलब, हम इस मुद्दे में बोले ही ना, क्या करें हम, बोले ना
आप बताइए ना, आप समाधान दीजिए। आपके बोलने से क्या हो रहा है संजय जी? आप बोले, शाइना बोले या सुब्रत जी बोले, किसी से कुछ फर्क नहीं पड़ रहा। बट विनोद, यू नो, नहीं नहीं, विवेक बंसल जी यू रिप्रेजेंट द कांग्रेस। नाउ वी जस्ट हैव प्लेड आउट अ रिस्पॉन्स दैट हैज कम इन फ्रॉम अ कांग्रेस एमपी प्रणीति शिंदे। शी सेज आग लगा देनी चाहिए थी, इतना हल्का प्रोटेस्ट क्यों हुआ है? व्हाट काइंड ऑफ अ रिमार्क्स आर नेताज मेकिंग?
Let me tell you that I am not a votary of this. This probably she overshot. She was getting too emotional about that.
Emotional?
We are the people who are going to be the role models of the society. Definitely. No. Let me just complete. Or if you don't want me to speak, then and if you are going to intercede like that or chip in like that, that this
no,
is
no. You get worked up. You sir get worked up in less than 10 seconds. But you want you want citizens to remain patient.
No. No, not citizens. You are not citizens. You are.
Of course, I am a citizen. Why not? I am a citizen.
You owe certain responsibility to the viewers.
No, do you want? Do you want me to play out what she has said?
Definitely a citizen. But that. Yeah, I know that. I am saying that. I am saying that this is not.
Will there be action against her? Will there be action against her? Or you can allow her to make such provocative statements?
No action. I am. No. I am nobody to take action on that. That is for the party must be taking cognizance of whatever their statements are coming. Hmm. So let me tell you that we have to be very responsible, and at the same time, this is what is expected. You see, this is a larger malice. This is that it cannot be put into the goal set of any particular party. Nobody approves of it. Nobody condones suicide.
Wow, you know, Bansal ji, all of you today are sounding so similar. All of you are sounding so similar. Whether it is the BJP, whether it is the Congress, whether it is the Shiv Sena, whether it is the Trinamool, because we ask you tough questions and then you people can't respond.
Whosoever. No, we are responding and we are giving a very balanced...
How are you responding? How can you let an MP, a member of parliament, make a comment like this?
No, I am... What do I... What am I supposed to say? I said that she exceeded a beef. She's not supposed to. I did say
that. You are saying she got over-emotional?
We are the...
You know,
public representatives. I said public representatives are role models of the society and this new generation. And we have to set such an example that they emulate us. They feel that they are in safe hands. That's what I'm saying. So, as far as all this problem is concerned, we have to... see it in a holistic manner, and just putting somebody in the dock or something of the sort, we should let
but
the
why do you believe? Do you believe? Now, Bansal ji, do you believe, before I get in BD Singh and Kasturi both, Bansal ji, do you believe that Mamata Banerjee is in the dock? Much like Eknath Shinde is in the dock for what happened in Badlapur.
No. In Badlapur, and as far as Mamata Banerjee is concerned, definitely... she should have been more forthright, and she should have said, she should not have been on the defense. She should have said the police needs to be hauled up, the administration of the hospital needs to be taken to the dock. How come all this, and they took cognizance of it and they tried to hush it up. These are serious issues.
So how can she then continue as a chief minister
happening with every sexual molestation? Sorry, continuation of chief minister. You see, rail accidents in this country are taking dime a dozen.
Bansal ji, please do not stoop to this level. हाथ से होते रहते हैं, लोग मरते रहते हैं, रेप होते रहते हैं, कोई फर्क नहीं पड़ता किसी नेता को.
नहीं, I didn't say कि हाथ से. Please.
No, Bansal ji, you cannot normalize this. We've had enough.
That these sort of things account. No, I am not normalizing. You are trying to put wrong words into my mouth. What I am saying is, definitely, if there these sort of established precedents are set up, very good. What is happening as a train accidents are... Did at any point of time rail minister offer to resign that these many accidents, and did he try to haul up the rail minister for that? What is happening? Dime a dozen.
So you want the rail minister to resign?
Day in and day out, the rail accidents are taking place.
You want Eknath Shinde to resign? You want Devendra Fadnavis to resign, but Mamata Banerjee must not resign?
Accountability should be uniform. This is what I'm saying.
Yes, that so take the lead now. आप लोगों की मोहब्बत की दुकान है. आपकी अपनी MP कहती है आग लगा दो. तो ये कौन सी मोहब्बत की दुकान है?
हाँ तो आग ने. अरे I said it, Baba. It is wrong. What you want? You want to shoot me for that?
Bansal ji, please don't get worked up. Don't get worked up. These are uncomfortable questions. देखिए आप वक्त अप हो रहे हैं. संजय गुप्ता जी मुस्कुरा रहे हैं क्योंकि वो आदि है इस तरह के सवालों के और जवाबों के भी. अब आई हैव टू गेट इट. बीडी सिंह साहब हियर, ही इज बीन वेरी पेशेंटली वेटिंग. कस्तूरी, यस. नाउ बीडी सिंह जी, अब आप मुझे बताइए, जो इतने सारे क्राइम अगेंस्ट वुमेन हो रहे हैं, हर नेता को साजिश नजर आती है. एकनाथ शिंदे जी भी कहते हैं ये तो कंस्पिरेसी हो रही है. लाडली बहल योजना को कोई हाईजैक करना चाहता है, कोई उस योजना से इतना परेशान है कि मेरे खिलाफ कंस्पिरेसी रच दी गई है. वहीं ममता बनर्जी को बंगाल में कंस्पिरेसी नजर आती है.
देखिए, एक माननीय एक शिंदे साहब जो महिला सुरक्षा के लेकर के काफी जो है सीरियस हैं, और जिस ढंग से देवेंद्र फडणवीस जी को जो है जो
नहीं, तो यह साजिश कैसे है सिंह साहब? ये साजिश कैसे, आप मुझे बताइए.
यस, मैं क्लियर करता हूँ. तो उन्होंने एक्यूज को अरेस्ट कराया है, और कल भी उन्होंने बोला है कि हम 3 महीने में फास्ट ट्रैक पे लेकर के इसके जो
नहीं सिंह साहब, साजिश क्या है, कंस्पिरेसी क्या है इसमें?
एक मिनट में उस पर भी आता हूँ. तो ये जो है सारी चीजें जो है वो सीरियस होकर 3 महीने में प्रॉमिस कर रहे हैं. अभी इसमें जो आज भी जो ये हुए प्रोटेस्ट हुए, जो इधर गाड़ियां तोड़ी गई है, जो भी है, और जो अभी परिणति जी का, परिणति शिंदे जी की जो है, आप कांग्रेस की जो एमपी है जो बोल रही थी ऐसे आग लगा देना चाहिए। देखिए मैं चलता हूँ, अभी इक्विज जो है वो कस्टडी के अंदर है और कोर्ट के मैटर जो कोर्ट जो भी, क्योंकि जो भारत का संविधान है वो।
आपने स्कूल के ओनर को क्यों नहीं पकड़ा है, स्कूल के ओनर को गिरफ्तार क्यों नहीं किया गया है, आप मुझे ये बताएंगे? वहां सीसीटीवी कैमराज नहीं चलते हैं, उसके लिए कौन जिम्मेदार है? इस व्यक्ति को वहां पर रखा गया, कोई थर्ड पार्टी चेक्स नहीं हुए, उसके लिए कौन जिम्मेदार है?
हेलो, उसकी इन्वेस्टिगेशन चालू है।
अरे उसमें क्या, स्कूल का ओनर कौन है, इसमें कौन सी बड़ी इन्वेस्टिगेशन चाहिए आपको सिंह साहब? आप जानते हैं कि स्कूल का ओनर कौन है या नहीं जानते?
नहीं, मैं सब जानता हूं, जो है वो
तो बताइए ना, नाम लीजिए उनका।
नहीं नहीं, पॉलिटिकल मुद्दे पे नहीं जाएंगे, लेकिन मैं ये कहना चाहता हूँ कि देखिए अभी जो महिला सुरक्षा का सब्जेक्ट है, इसको किस तरह से सुलझाया जाए, वो न चल के अभी अपोजिट पार्टी जो कांग्रेस है या जो भी एमबीए है, जो महाविकास अघाड़ी या महाविनाश अघाड़ी जो भी ग्रुप है, वो क्या है कि इसको तूल देना चाहते हैं कि कैसे इसको।
नहीं नहीं, सुनिए सुनिए, अब देखिए सिंह साहब, अब दिक्कत ये हो गई है कि अगर आप कोलकाता में ममता बनर्जी के खिलाफ प्रदर्शन करते हैं और वो जायज है, तो यहीं पर अगर ऑपोजिशन आप लोगों के खिलाफ प्रोटेस्ट करता है वो भी तो जायज हुआ ना। अगर आप पॉलिटिक्स खेल रहे हैं बंगाल में, तब मैं कहूंगी कि ऑपोजिशन यहाँ पॉलिटिक्स खेल रहा है, आप मानेंगे ये बात?
मैं समझ गया पालली, आप कलकत्ता की बात करें तो कलकत्ता में जो है ममता बनर्जी ने क्या है कि वो टाइम को किल कर रही थी कि मैं सीबीआई को संडे के बाद या इसके 7 दिन बाद बोलेंगे, जबकि उसे भारतीय जनता पार्टी जो हम लोग की महायुति है, हाँ, उन्होंने किसी भी तरह से सीबीआई का दिया जो है, सीबीआई आरडी कई लोगों को
यूज किया। अच्छा, सिंह साहब अब आप रुकिए, अब आप मुझे बताएंगे कि ये पूरी घटना जो बदलापुर में होती है, आप लोगों को कब पहली इन्फॉर्मेशन मिलती है और कब एफआईआर लॉन्च की जाती है, आपको पता है घटनाक्रम और क्या डेट्स थे सर?
देखिए घटनाक्रम जो भी हो, लेकिन जो है जहां तक मुझे जानकारी है कि जो घटनाक्रम हुआ उसके विदिन 24 आवर जो है इक्विज जो है अरेस्ट किए गए, इससे बड़ी जो है
एफआईआर लिखवाने में पेरेंट्स ने कितना वेट किया, कितनी बार उन्होंने चक्कर लगाया पुलिस स्टेशन के, आप जानते हैं क्या?
देखिए महाराष्ट्र में क्या है, दूसरे जगह जैसे जो पुलिस का जो भी चक्कर हो मुझे नहीं मालूम, लेकिन महाराष्ट्र की ये खासियत ये है कि एफआईआर करने से पहले पूरी जो है इन्वेस्टिगेशन कर लेते हैं, सामने वाले को चेक करते हैं, करते हैं वो
बिल्कुल। और यही तो सिंह साहब आरोप ये लग रहा है कि क्योंकि पॉलिटिकल कनेक्शंस हैं, आपने मामले को दबाने की कोशिश की। अगर जनता कल इस तरह सड़कों पर नहीं उतरती तो नीदर शाइना नॉर सिंह साहब आप इसमें कोई एक्शन लेते। अब ऑपोजिशन का ये आरोप है, दोनों बंसल साहब और संजय गुप्ता जी ने सवाल उठा लिए आप लोगों के ऊपर, और यू नो कस्तूरी, I'm just at a loss of words when you hear everyone. I'm not able to figure out, you know, which is the neta from which political party. They're all sounding similar. You'll have to unmute yourself.
One second. Deepti,
listening to all the political representatives on this panel, and I'm sorry, my blood is boiling. It's ridiculous. How much of double standards was on display right now on your show when everybody is on the back foot when it comes to their party's involvement and very quick to accuse the other person?
The BJP representative was happy to talk about it. When you ask them about Maharashtra, absolute whataboutry, absolute running around in circles. And I'm sorry, Mr. Vivek Bansali, the kind of attitude that you showed, I mean, most people here on this panel are finding it frustrating that they are having to answer these questions. It was so difficult. We guys are so, the media is so ununderstanding and indifferent, all the effort, the amazing effort that the government of these states are putting in. And we have to explain to you the kind of mansplaining I just listened to. I'm sorry, this is not done. This is about the safety of... I'm sorry, but this is about 3 and 4-year-old children. This is about doctors in their place of work.
Exactly.
Agreed, we cannot compare the two. Agreed that the crime in Thane, the crime in Badlapur, could be construed as an individual's perversion, but that's not what the furor is about.
Hmm.
It agreed that it was one person, one pervert, one horrible man. But why was that not? People had to go on social media to even get Fox so involved. But Fox so was not involved in this. Do you know that?
Yes.
Until public, ridiculous.
Yes, and you know, Kasturi, because you've raised that very direct and a good question to both Vivek Bansalji, Shaina NC. Before Vivek Bansalji, moves out of the show, I am just seeking his indulgence for at least the next 2 to 3 minutes, Shaina. That's all that I need from all of you. You know, just think about these people who've been out on the streets. They've been bracing the rain, the lathis, the stones, everything, the brickbats. The kind of language our netas have used, Kasturi, for them. You know, someone from the Trinamool also saying, Subrat ji, ki ladkiyan raat mein aa rahi hain yahan par protest karne taki apne boyfriend se mil le. Ab usme bhi agar aapko saazish dikhegi, to I do not know aapko saazish kaise kaise aur kahan kahan dikh sakti hai. But Bansal ji, what does morality say today? Who today is accountable for what has happened?
You see, everybody, somehow I'm in all fairness, in all objectivity, what I have to say is, somehow unfortunate aspect is everybody is there to shield himself or defend himself. Nobody is taking the bull by the horn, where the malice lies. And nobody is coming forward to put anybody, how so high and mighty he may be, just to assuage the feelings of the people. And assure them that sternest action would be taken. Nobody needs to be sure.
Do you remember 2012, the Nirbhaya so case, Bansal ji? You would.
Yeah. And
so what
I
changed?
Would like to ask, because who was orchestrating it at that point of time? So now, why these people are completely, taken shelters in their houses. They should come. They should be vocal and vociferous about it.
Who are you talking about?
Whatever, beat me, Maharashtra, beat me. And I'm talking about UP as well. In UP, innumerable cases, Hathras cases.
Bilkul, UP or Hathras, zarur baat karni hai. Bengal par baat kare na kare. Uttar Pradesh, Hathras pe zarur baat karni hai, Bansal ji.
Shahjahanpur, their own MLA, BJP's MLA had been, the way he had been exploiting a female. And mass rape had been taking place. And what else?
Okay, I just want to give. I have 30 seconds. I want to give this to Shaina. Shaina, who according to you is accountable?
The state government in every particular case is accountable. Our chief minister has taken it upon himself. That is the first step, Vicky, when you accept that there has been a wrongdoing. If there has been a slip, be it the part of the administration or the police or civil society. Unfortunately, what we saw in Maharashtra is the most heinous, dastardly act that one cannot even visualize. So heads need to roll. The SIT in place, working, the CBI in place, working, and the citizens ensuring. I think the time has come for all of us to introspect and say, bete ko samjhao, bete ko sikhao. Gone are the days of casting aspersions on women.
Netaon ki koi zimmedari nahi aur unme se bahut sare neta assemblies aur parliament mein baithte hai, Shaina. Don't forget this. It's easy to raise questions on people. And okay. I want to thank Shaina, Kasturi and all gentlemen. But before all of you go, Bansal ji has already taken off his earpiece, so he would not be able to hear this. But for other guests who are still remaining, I want you to spend just next the 2 minutes listening in to what we have gotten for you. This is from the year 2016, when you had India's most celebrated lyricist, Prasoon Joshi, who pens this poem that was on the girl child. It had put to shame anyone who regretted the birth of a girl child. A poem that celebrates the achievements of our women. 8 years later, as the country is rallying, ladies and gentlemen, for justice for its betis, the lines of this poem are both ironic and relevant in the current times. We leave you with an audiovisual rendition of Prasoon Joshi's 2016 poem. This is titled, Sharm Aa Rahi Hai Na.
Sharm Aa Rahi Hai Na? शर्म आ रही है ना उस समाज को जिसने उसके जन्म पर खुल के जश्न नहीं मनाया। शर्म आ रही है ना उस पिता को उसके होने पर जिसने एक दिया कम जलाया। शर्म आ रही है ना उन रस्मों को, उन रिवाजों को, उन बेड़ियों को, उन दरवाजों को। शर्म आ रही है ना उन बुजुर्गों को जिन्होंने उसके अस्तित्व को सिर्फ अंधेरों से जोड़ा। शर्म आ रही है ना उन दुपट्टों को, उन लिबासों को जिन्होंने उसे अंदर से तोड़ा। शर्म आ रही है ना स्कूलों को, दफ्तरों को, रास्तों को, मंजिलों को। शर्म आ रही है ना उन शब्दों को, उन गीतों को जिन्होंने उसे कभी शरीर से ज्यादा नहीं समझा। शर्म आ रही है ना राजनीति को, धर्म को, जहां बार बार अपमानित हुए उसके स्वप्न। शर्म आ रही है ना खबरों को, मिसालों को, दीवारों को, भालों को। शर्म आनी चाहिए हर ऐसे विचार को, शर्म आनी चाहिए जिसने पंख काटे थे उसके। शर्म आनी चाहिए ऐसे हर ख्याल को, शर्म आनी चाहिए जिसने रोका था उसे आसमान की तरफ देखने से। शर्म आनी चाहिए हम सबको, क्योंकि जब मुट्ठी में सूरज लिए नन्ही सी बिटिया सामने खड़ी थी, तब हम उसकी उंगलियों से छलकती रोशनी नहीं, उसका लड़की होना देख रहे थे। उसकी मुट्ठी में था आने वाला कल, और हम सब देख रहे थे मटमैला आज। पर सूरज को तो धूप खिलाना था, बेटी को तो सवेरा लाना था, और सुबह होकर रही।